Hi, welcome to Jamie Oliver Live from London. It's a beautiful day. It's about 6 o'clock-ish. What's the time?
6:30.
6:30 it is in England, and it's lovely, beaming out to the whole wide world. We are cooking in my test kitchen. I have pans on, full of water, but there's nothing happening inside them yet. We have three cameras today. We have the lovely Matt here, holding that camera. Then we have Rat Boy. Matt, shoot Rat Boy. There's Rat Boy, wave at Matt. That's it, look at him, isn't he cute? He's on that camera, let's have that camera. Hi, locked off wide shot. And then we have this little shot here, which is our close-up shot, which will probably be a bit rubbish, but I'll do my best. Anyway, we are celebrating lots of things. Cooking, simple cooking today. We're gonna be taking questions from Twitter. So if you want to ask questions, you can ask live. Just do that funny little hash button, what do you call it?
Hashtag.
Hashtag ask Jamie. Hashtag ask Jamie. You know it makes sense. Okay, so ask any questions and I'll be rattling out. Over here we have the lovely Liz. She'll be asking questions. Over there we have Richard. You might have seen him on Crime Watch before. And then there's Louise next. Just a quick, and don't sound too long because she doesn't like it. Okay. Who?
Reinstated. I was
sacked
on that.
Oh, absolutely. Yes, if you remember last week, she was sacked live on air. I've given her job back.
And you're happy about that?
I'm happy about that. And that is because I'm a generous kind of person, okay? Anyway, okay, so guys, we're going to talk about lots of different stuff today. Any questions to kick off with lovely Liz?
Yeah, we've got r.sydney asking, can you ride tandem?
What? Can I ride tandem? No. Next question, Liz?
What, Jibberdy?
Have we mic'd up Liz this week? Oh, that's good. We have sound.
Jibberdy is asking, when did you first learn to cook?
Okay, I learned to cook when I was about 8 years old. I grew up in a pub restaurant in Essex, and basically when I went downstairs, there was like seven chefs. I started off in the wash-up, sort of scrubbing and peeling veg, and then eventually I got a job with the big boys. That was great, yeah, so 8 years old. And now my little girl, Daisy, she's starting to cook already. The other one's not interested, but Daisy, she loves it, so I had a chopping at the weekend. Next one, Bubba.
Sheva,
yeah.
Is asking, what do you pack for your kids' lunch?
Nothing. They have a hot meal at school, which is pretty good. Yeah, so no packed lunches. Although I've got nothing against packed lunches, they can be very good. Although about 75% of packed lunches are worse than the worst school lunches. I've seen terrible things in packed lunches. I mean, like, you wouldn't believe. I've seen loads of kids going to school with cold leftover fast food burgers, just tins of energy drinks. The funniest, not well, it's not funny, it's a bit sad really, the last packed lunch that took my breath away was a whole packed lunch box just full of just brownies. It was like my wife's idea of heaven. Apart from that was this child's lunch. But there you go. Shall I introduce a bit of cooking?
Yeah.
Liz, well, okay. So look, I'm going to do, I kind of made up what we were going to cook not so long ago. I'm going to do a really quick pasta dish. If there's any good questions coming in, Liz, just interrupt me, no worries. So we've got regular pasta here. Obviously, you guys have all got this kind of stuff. So you all know how to cook it. You just follow the packet instructions. I've got some boiling salted water. I wanted to kind of just, you know this stuff, right? And of course you can use this stuff. I wanted to show you a little birthday present that I got the other day from my mentor, Gennaro Contaldo. Rat Boy, if you could come down here, my darling. If we had budget, which we don't, we'd have some nice music now. Rat Boy, please come on. Rat Boy's our runner. How old are you, Rat Boy?
14.
14 years old. Just look at him, isn't he lovely?
I've been here 8 years.
8 years, look at that jumper, close up of that jumper. Wouldn't you be proud if that was your boy? Nice. How's your love life at the moment?
Non-existent.
Non-existent, okay.
14 years.
Oh.
People are asking if Rat Boy is single.
Rat Boy, are you single?
Very.
Very single, okay. So Rat Boy, don't get too comfortable up here because I think the public like you. That's my immediate reaction. Twitter's going hot for you. Okay, just come over here, Mr. Can you get over here or have you got a wire? Okay, let me come to you. So, you might be thinking, what is Oliver doing? This is a birthday present. And you might be thinking, what is that bottle opener? It's not. This is basically, Rat Boy, where's my dyes? Where do you put the dyes?
Sorry.
He's like, he's a bit young and, you know. So, what we got here, this is from Gennaro. Basically, this is dyes here. And you can see each end has a slightly different end. You can get these online And email, you know, I think they're about sort of 40 quid, 50 quid. I'm not expecting everyone in the world to have one, of course. I just thought it's quite cool to have a look. You've got tagliatelle there. You've got a spaghetti there. And you can basically do like a little rigatoni there. It's really cool. It's a brilliant birthday present if you've got a friend, Ratboy, thank you. Friend that likes to cook and you don't know what to get them. And this is what Gennaro did. And you put the different ends on it. And then what I thought I'd do is just show you how damn simple it is to make pasta. I'll do it super quick with one egg and 100 grams of flour. So I've just got they call it Tipo 00, which is basically how fine, you can see that's like fine, like talcum powder. Waz it up, and you can do it in a bowl with a fork, but you literally waz it up, it'll come together, it'll start cleaning the side of the board, and then you can just sort of knead it. But it's so quick, but it's a great recipe to sort of be able to learn, because one egg, 100 grams of flour, any raving idiot in the whole wide world can remember that. I can. Right, boy? How do you make that pasta? How much egg?
2 eggs.
You're just playing it now. You're just playing the game. One egg, 100 grams of flour. Just come and have a look at this. We could have our little camera here, if it's any good, I don't know. Let's have a little look. Just gonna pour that out. So literally, the reason I'm showing you this is because if you've got a food processor, or you can get busy with it, in literally a minute, you can come home, 2 eggs, 200 grams of flour, you've got beautiful homemade pasta that costs literally nothing for you and your wife, and you just you knead it around like a kid here, just for 30 seconds, and you come up with this lovely little ball, like this. Any questions over there, Liz?
A lot of interest about Ratboy and his jumper.
Okay.
But aside from that, we had one saying, what's the weirdest thing you've ever cooked or eaten?
Okay, what is the weirdest thing I've ever cooked or eaten? Probably the weirdest thing, I mean, I have eaten a lot of bulls in my time. Bullocks I have eaten. Not bad if you trim them up and flour them or deep fry them, they can be very nice. As they say in Wyoming, Rocky Mountain oysters. Very nice, didn't mind those. When I was in Japan, I did have a surprise with cod semen. Yeah, I thought it was chicken on a skewer. It wasn't, it was cod semen, and when I chewed it, it just went everywhere. That wasn't great. But generally I'm pretty good with everything. Anyway, okay, so that's what we've got, okay? We've got this little dough. It's so simple. Honestly, if you're making it for 2 or 4 or 6 people and you've got a food processor, we're talking about 2 minutes all in, right? Now, what's the closest you can get around here, big boy? Do you want me to move this table?
Yeah.
Rat boy, can I have you?
Yes, you can.
I mean, I don't want to have you, but can I have you? Okay, over here, Rat boy. So, Rat boy is going to come and demonstrate something very beautiful here. Not only his jumper. Can we just take that off? Because I think people actually want to see the parrot.
Definitely.
Fair enough. Where did you get the jumper?
Unnamed High Street Outlet.
Really?
Yeah.
What do you mean unnamed? This is the web, you can say what you like.
Top Man.
Wow, so to the designer at Top Man, when was this?
It was in the vintage section, so it probably wasn't.
Oh, so they didn't make it.
Top Man. It's Fruit of the Moon.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
Okay, which is a generic jumper. So someone printed that. God bless you, maybe a parrot lover. So if you'd like to straddle that, Rat Boy.
Nothing more.
Okay, so we have the dough, okay? And then what Rat Boy's going to do is he's going to open this up and... Oh, sorry. we're going to push this pasta in here. Have we got a close-up of that, Matt? So we put the pasta in here. We've got a close-up, big boy? Okay, we push that in. And then Rat Boy's very good with wrenches, right? Aren't you, Rat Boy?
I definitely am.
Okay, so go.
Yep.
You have a little go on that. And then we're going to extrude it. Now, look, of course... I know you guys haven't got this jumper or this piece of equipment at home, and then just hold it there, Rat Boy, just hold it there. I know you haven't got this equipment, but you can roll it out with a rolling pin and cut it up with a knife, or, let's be really honest, the recipe I'm going to show you, you could just use dry pasta, but I want to show you my birthday present, and it's kind of cool. Now, I'm just going to put a little flour into here, right, and we're going to receive Rat Boy. So, okay. Have we got a can you get down here? You can't get any closer. That's such a limitation. How about this? Does this go a long way? Let's see. How long can this go, big boy? Let's see. We love a bit of live broadcast. We're really good at this. We're only playing with this, guys. Okay. Don't you just love a bit of technology? Ratboy, think about the kind of movies that you could make at home with that jumper.
Yeah, I'm there.
I think your jumper's going to cause a revolution in America. Okay, go, Ratboy. Yeah. So as you can see, the muscular man that he is. Can you see that, Rich? Richard, can you see it?
Yeah.
Yes, do you want me to move?
Are you receiving me?
It's wonderful.
Okay, is that too? Is that too close? Okay, so we Ratboy, I'm receiving Ratboy, and he's making beautiful fettuccine or tagliolini, whichever you want to call it. Are you happy, Ratboy? Is this your finest moment? Yes or no?
This is my finest hour.
Okay.
I've never made pasta before.
Bless you. And how does it feel?
I've never had Jamie Oliver receive my
pasta. Okay, well, there's always a first time. Okay, so we've got the pasta coming out. You heard a little noise in the background. That was Louise there. Moving on. Okay, so we've got the pasta. And anyway, I just think that's a wicked little birthday present. Thank you very much, Gennaro. I love you. You're the best. We've got homemade pasta there. If you want one of these pasta machines, you can get them online. The brand is called... I don't know, I will find out and I'll put it on. The brand is called, oh my lord, Boutini. B-O-T-T-E-N-E. I know you can get it online because Gennaro did. Thank you, Ratboy. Round of applause for Ratboy, everyone. He's a beautiful thing. Okay, let's get on with this pasta. So, look, in the real world, you guys can get your nice tagliolini or tagliatelle. I want to show you a pasta that I'm really excited about. We've got fast rolling boiling water here. We're going to put salt in it. My wife often gets a little bit funny about putting the salt in, but I try and explain to her not all the salt is going to go in your body is going to go down the sink, okay? But you want to season the water, otherwise the pasta will taste horrible. I want to show you an uncooked sauce that I'm kind of excited about. Its history is rooted in Sicilian Italian cooking. So what we're going to do is take a microplane. We're going to get a lemon from somewhere over here. There's so much flavour in this zest here, and we don't want to waste it. And you only have to like push that zest, and you can see it getting shiny, and that's the oils and the fragrance coming out. So I just want the zest of one lemon, and I don't know how close you can get, but these little microplanes are brilliant. For getting just the lovely fragrant part off. And what we're basically going to make is a glorified dressing. So I'll finish this dressing and then we'll take a few more questions. The lemon juice goes in, the juice of one lemon. This would be enough sauce for like two people. So in with the lemon. And then we're going to add Parmesan cheese. You could use a pecorino. You could use any local cheese that has that same sort of dense saltiness that gives you the same sort of emotion when you grate it. So we're going to go in with the Parmesan, and you can blend cheeses as well, which is nice. So just like a little handful there. And then I'm going to add some olive oil. Now this will look like I'm putting a lot in. It's not. It's the smallest little thread of oil in the world. It just doesn't come out very fast. So you've got about four tables of olive oil. Four tablespoons of olive oil in there. And we're not going to season it yet because it might not...